Hi, everybody. My name is Kacie Athey, and I am the specialty crops entomologist for the University of Illinois. And I'm down here at Dixon Springs, where we're doing a project here in the high tunnels investigating natural enemy control of pests. So we are looking at a different control method for insect infestations within high tunnels, and we're looking at using natural enemies instead of using insecticide sprays. So with high tunnels, there isn't a lot of research on some of the control methods that we can use within high tunnels, and especially not when it comes to actually releasing natural enemies like lady beetles and that sort of thing to try to control pest problems. And so that's what we're investigating down here, to see if we can use natural enemies to control pests as opposed to using insecticide sprays. So we are ordering our natural enemies from a company called BioBest. Now, there's a few things to note when you're ordering natural enemies. You actually want to contact the company. So you want to call and you want to talk to somebody. You want to tell them what you're growing and let them make recommendations about what they think you should be purchasing. Then you can purchase the natural enemies that you want, and they come in different containers. So this was the predatory mites. This container holds the predatory mites. And the top of it just looks like it's like a salt shaker or something. And so you really do just shake them out over the plant. This container held the aureus, which are little predatory bugs. And then this one, we just kind of opened up and we just sort of pour like that. And you can see the top of the lid is open with air holes, you know, because the bugs need to breathe. They do come full of some kind of a medium. This came full of some nutshells of some sort. And this one came full of sawdust, because as the bugs are being shipped, you want to kind of keep them away from each other, because they will eat each other if they encounter each other. So that's why they're shipped that way. So when you open it, it looks like somebody just sent you a thing full of sawdust, but it really is full of mites. Same goes here. It'll look like you've been sent a thing full of nuts. It is predatory bugs, but this is not the only company to order from. There are many. And oftentimes within a state, you might have some smaller companies that specialize in one or two things. But I want to reiterate that you really need to contact the company first and see what they recommend for what you are trying to control. Because so many of these natural enemies are pretty specific. This one is not. This one is much more generalist, but a lot of our natural enemies are really specific for what they are good for controlling. Actually, right here too are both of the media that they come in. So all this right here is from the mites being sprinkled on the leaves. So on these strawberries, you can see all these spider mites, which are doing this stippling damage as well. And so what we're trying to do in here is we're trying to cut those down using natural enemies. And so what we started with is a combination of some natural enemies. So we started with this type of mite, which is a predatory mite, that not only eats these spider mites, but also eats something called thrips. And then we also use these aureus. They're little true bugs, and they eat pretty much everything. But what we're finding is that this particular species is not doing the trick in these strawberries. You can see this infestation up here, all of this webbing and all those little dots on there, that's all spider mite infestation. And so what we're gonna try now is a different species of natural enemy that specifically eats spider mites. It's pretty much its only food. With the idea that when you're using natural enemies, if something isn't quite working, there are a lot of options out there. There's a variety of things you can use, and you always want to pay attention to the pests that your natural enemies are supposed to be controlling, much like using any kind of insecticidal spray. It's the same idea, except you're using something that's alive instead of a spray. So hopefully we will get our other predators next week, and hopefully we'll see some improvement in this in the coming weeks once we get the really, really specific predator put on these spider mite infestations. Now, in addition to the predators we put in here, we also find lots of spiders in these strawberries and other lady beetles that come into the tunnel and other things that can help with this infestation as well. So if we continue to add natural enemies, what we hope happens is the infestation goes down without having to actually spray a broad-spectrum insecticide that could really disrupt some of the other interactions that are happening with some of the other natural enemies. pests out within this tunnel.
You get sooty mold with feeding from things like aphids, white flies, scales, and it's because aphids and all of those, and here, they suck into the plant, and they suck the phloem out, and they poop out sugar. And so when they poop out sugar and the sugar's all over the leaf, then you get this sooty mold growth, and it can cause issues. It can actually get on your fruit, and that can be a big problem as well. But then in addition, if you look at the back of this leaf, this actually shows us some of our natural enemy activity at work. So you can see these little yellow guys, tiny little yellow guys, those are all aphids. But if you see these brown guys, these puffy looking ones, those are all evidence of parasitoids. So a wasp has attacked that aphid and put her egg in there, and the developing next wasp is in that shell. And she'll come out, and then she'll go and parasitize another aphid. So that is good evidence of some of our natural enemies at work. Now, these aren't ones we've released in here. These are ones that were naturally occurring, but you would expect to find parasitoids within a high tunnel because they could come in from the outside and attack the aphids within the tunnel. Now, this plant is really infested with aphids. That's why you're seeing this sooty mold. You would hope to have your parasitoids sort of get them under control before they're at this level, but if the parasitoids are doing their job, this plant may recover just fine. You can see the aphids have not gotten really up to the upper leaves yet. They start towards the bottom. And that's why you're seeing the sooty mold on the bottom, but you're really not seeing it up top. And then, as an added bonus, you do have some new growth on this plant that is healthy as well, even down towards the bottom. And so that's a good sign. So we're using the sticky traps primarily to assess the pests within the high tunnels. So they are yellow. It's a color that a lot of insects are attracted to. And so we use them to monitor aphids, the spider mites, the thrips, that sort of thing, and anything else that's occurring in the tunnel. We change these out weekly, and we're going through and IDing everything that's on them to get an idea of what the insect community within these tunnels actually looks like. And then we can also look at the differences between, you know, the various tunnels. And it's not always going to be pests, of course, it's a variety of other things too. And we do like to know, as far as predators go, we like to know kind of everything that's in here because that's what's available for food for the predators, who might not necessarily be eating our pests. When you're using natural enemies, it does take longer than it's gonna take for spray. So there is a level of patience you have for it to actually work, which is why you'll sometimes see like more of an infestation and then it will go down, the predators will catch up. The other thing that you're hoping that the predators will do within the tunnel is they'll actually reproduce in the tunnel, and then they'll give you more season-long control as their populations build up. You don't generally get control beyond one season. Usually have to re-release, but you're hoping to get control throughout the season with releases. Project down here at Dixon Springs and up at the Student Sustainability Farm on campus is an extension collaboration grant. And so we're really trying to get some preliminary data about whether or not these natural enemies work to control the pests in high tunnels. And then we're hoping to go to the growers and give some recommendations about whether or not we think that these pests will be effective for them or not. And so even though there are some different plants in the high tunnels between the sites, we hope to learn a lot about whether or not these predators are effective within high tunnel systems.